Hey guys, Merch776 here, bringing you guys another video to pretty much help you guys, you know, get better aim and win more gunfights. So, pretty much the first thing that we're going to get into is your sensitivity. Your sensitivity is key. If you have too high of a sensitivity, yeah, you can turn on players better, but you're limiting yourself to winning gunfights that you have to turn on people with. When, you know, head-on-head combat fights, you're going to be all over the place instead of, you know, having more of a, I guess, let's use this mannequin as an example. So if I was this far away from the mannequin and I have a low sensitivity, I can easily just wreck that mannequin. But if I have a high sensitivity, let's say I play on a 10, or no, even a 14, let's say I play on 14, okay, whoa, Jesus Christ, I'm not used to this. And I try and win a gunfight, you're gonna be all over the place, pretty much. And Jesus Christ, I cannot handle that. Anyways, that's just pretty much what I have to say about your sensitivity. You know, just don't turn it down very low. Just gradually, let's say you're playing at 10, go down to like 7, play a few games at 7, and then play a few games at like 6, and then play a few games at like 5, and whatever you feel comfortable with. Just stick at whatever you're comfortable with. You know, I'm not saying 5 and 4 for your 5 for your horizontal and 4 for your vertical is the best. That's just what works for me. The second thing that we're gonna go into is actually gonna change the buttons that you fire with. Instead of using the L2 and the R2 to aim and fire, you're going to be firing with your L1 and R1, which pretty much makes it so that, you know. This is only for PlayStation 4. Xbox doesn't really have to worry about this because with their controllers are set up, they have more of a hair trigger instead of a whatever PlayStation has. I don't know what you call it, but it takes longer to aim down and do that and stuff. You know, when gunfights, pretty much, it's a lot harder. You know. It's faster if you just change your settings so that your button layout was flipped so you ADS with L1 and you fire with R1. It's just because they're buttons. They're not triggers. They're buttons. So it's just faster to press buttons than it would be a trigger. Like I said, that only pertains to PlayStation. Okay, that's PlayStation 3 and PS4. The next thing that we're going to go into is your button layout. This is optional. Okay. So, pretty much what I use is I use R3 to crouch and go prone. And I use circle to melee. And that makes it easier so that when I'm aiming and I'm sliding into people, I don't really have to, like, it's easier to hip fire and I don't have to take my thumbs off of the joysticks. That just makes it a lot easier to win gunfights. Personally, this one's optional, but I think that it will help you out a lot. Okay, you know, it takes a while to get used to, like, everything on this list, but, you know, I think it's worth it in the long run. Just try it out, see how you like it. If you don't like it, then you don't have to do it. I'm just saying, it helps me in gunfights anyways. The last thing that we're going to be getting into today is your controller vibration. Your controller vibration, when you have it on, it creates a lot of, I guess, motion in your hands than you really need. I used to play with controller vibration back in Black Ops 2, and when I started playing Black Ops 3, I was like, okay, let's turn off controller vibration and see how it do. And I've personally been doing a lot better without controller vibration, so I've kept it off. This one is optional. But I think it just helps a lot not having that extra controller vibration. It helps you in gunfights, because, you know, I don't know, it helps. I can't really think of why. But anyways, that's going to be it for this list, guys. I hope you guys enjoy your day. Love, peace, and apple grease.